Talks, I believe. It is the 1st of September. Happy September, everyone. But then Tunsil goes over to the Texans, right? Texans got him. And just completely boosted that line. So, like, it's going to clear up time for Deshaun. It's going to help out those running backs like Dookie. And I believe the Texans also signed Carlos Hyde yesterday. But the Dolphins got rid of Jarvis Landry, who was a poison to that locker room. That owner wanted him gone. They got rid of Tunsil. They got rid of Kiko, who I don't like anyhow. He's a former Bills. He's a dirty player. That's why I don't like him. I'm not bitter about him leaving. I liked him in Buffalo, but I'm glad a guy like that is gone. I'm not a Seahawks hater, although I did just read that the Hawks cut Geno Smith, which I don't care about that. They probably should have never had Geno Smith to begin with. The bigger news with that is the fact that the Russell Wilson is the only quarterback now on the Seahawks roster. That's what I meant. Who did I say? Not Landry. They got rid of Stills. Kenny Stills. I'm sorry, Justin. I don't think they got rid of another one. It was Stills. Stills was the one that talked crap on the owner. Didn't want to be there. And Landry's not with them. Landry's with the Browns, if I said Landry, for some reason. And that's the other thing. I was going to get into that then, too. So the Chiefs get rid of... Good luck, everybody. The Chiefs get rid of... Carlos Hyde, trade him to the Texans, and then on top of that, we start out with this. You got to be kidding me. We're going to start out with the P word. The Chiefs sign McCoy out of 100, Damian Harris. The Chiefs sign McCoy. Like, that to me, so love McCoy in Philly. He did okay in Buffalo. I wasn't a fan of him in Buffalo. He just never excited me in Buffalo too much. But I love him on the Chiefs, man. McCoy ought to be shooting up draft boards. So I said if I was able to get Singletary. All right, we're going to get 400 points, which means I'm going to give away $5 hitless credits. $5 in hitless credits and a little bit of Bryce Love. Bryce Love, man, in deeper leagues ought to be getting a look. Bryce Love going out to the Washington Redskins. That's going to be Chris England. Yeah, I mean, I'll ask you guys, you tell me, what was the biggest breaking news last night, yesterday for you? Maybe it affected your team, maybe it affected your fantasy team, maybe you were just a bystander and you were like, what the F just happened? Guys, what was the biggest fantasy breaking news, or even NFL news? It doesn't have to be fantasy, like Tunsil, you know, and I think this is something that as I get more in the fantasy, it does affect. Tunsil definitely affects, this is out of 75, Sutton for the Broncos. Oh, former Broncos receiver Demaryius Thomas released from the Patriots, but it sounds like they're leaving the option open for him to come back in on a different contract. I don't know what it is. Here's a guy staying on draft boards. Mr. Jason Witten. Canton Absolute out of 199 going to the Cowboys. What up, Trey? There you go. Canton Absolute. Wonder if Zeke signs today. It sounds like he's going to be missing a couple, like a week or two. He's going to pull the old Emmett Smith. And out of 35 for the Niners, going to my boy Josh Long. I don't want to do an update right now. Josh Long getting the Niners, coming in late and snagging them. How about a Dante Pettis out of 35 for you there, Josh? That'll work. The Broncos want him back? Oh, I heard the Broncos right now are shopping for QB. All around the Texans move, Jamar. I think the Texans just put themselves in a position to be a contender for the Super Bowl. I really do. The Tunsil move, getting another piece at running back. You know, who did Stills go to the Texans too? I can't remember where he went. Yeah, Scott, are you excited about Clowney? I mean, that's a big trade. I can't believe you're not excited, but how much does that affect? Do the and honestly, Scott, do the Seahawks have enough in place So here's always my thing is, can a team survive without a quarterback? Like, can they make do? Right? Like, for, and it always goes back to the Eagles. Nick Foles won the Super Bowl as a backup quarterback. I think the question becomes, and then a few years ago, who was it? They lost their quarterback and then lost like six games straight, completely fell apart. You know, can you survive without your starting quarterback? Is your team equipped to do that? And right now, the Seahawks aren't. They don't even have a backup quarterback. Out of 100, Calvin Johnson and Campbell. God forbid, you know, God forbid that they'll have to re-sign like Geno if that happens. But, you know, Russell Wilson, out of 100, Calvin gets injured in week one. Like, nobody can come in and know that offense that quick. It'd have to be Geno. Geno. How about a N'Keal Harry for the New England Patriots? Going out to Richard Blaney. A nanny auto. There you go. N'Keal Harry patch auto. And that is the end of that first box. One down, few to go. Let's get excited. Guys, be on the lookout. Tomorrow starts, we'll be opening up that fantasy page for invites. Like, we're going to do a giveaway for that. There is a give. I did already run the Show Your Hits giveaway. Congratulations to Richard, Josh Gibson, and, oh man, who was the other one? Oh, I forgot. It's posted on the page. I tagged everyone who won. We'll draft your prizes up and crack those tonight. I also have to draw for the Absolute giveaway that ended yesterday, and I will be posting another one today, and it's really just a sign-up form. I want to get everyone's birthdays and email addresses, and because I want to do some more things with birthdays. Raquel Armstead out of 100. Oh, yeah, Corey. Corey won. How could I forget? I don't know who Mago is. Is that the backup quarterback that nobody knows, Alex Mago? It's Alex Mago, right? Like, dude, there's no response needed. You just said Mago coming back. Cool. That's like saying that, I mean, Geno Smith is coming back. Yeah, Alex Mago, yeah. Yeah, I'm not, that's cool. Good for Seattle. They need, yeah. What are they doing, Scott? They just don't feel like Russ. They think Russell Wilson's inevitable. Or inevitable. Like, indestructible. Ortega Whiteside for the Philadelphia Eagles. Going out to Maximus. What up, Max? Hit Max with his drop. Not the mama. Ortega Whiteside. And Austin Bryant out of 35 for the Detroit Lions. Going out to Pete, a Lions fan. There you go, Pete. Get after it now. Scott, you sound like a Patriots fan. Like, the way you talk about the Seahawks. I do like the Seahawks a lot more than I like the Patriots. I just feel like, man, it's... After they were so strong with that defense and had all that stuff in place, they just, the Patriots, you talk about they're a step ahead, but I feel like Seattle, it just did not plan ahead very well. They had their instant gratification in line, and they got to the Super Bowl, and that's what they wanted, and then there was no plan after that. Out of 100, Larry Fitzgerald, who I'm surprised, he's going a lot sooner and a lot of drafts than I thought he would. People still believe in this dude. I can't help but believe till that he's going to last the full year. You know, bold prediction, he retires midseason. I don't know. And LJ Collier for the Seahawks out of 199 going to Scotty. Here we go. Let's get into some of these hitties. How about a Drew Lock out of 99 for them Denver Broncos? There we go. Drew Lock. Who was placed on injured reserve is my understanding. That's what I was told. I don't know if it's temporary for the season or what. Did he get hurt? I think he's the guy there in the future. I don't think you're not going to see him. People like him. He'll be there. It's just I don't think it's going to happen this year. Yeah, I thought so, Kelly. Why? Did he get hurt? Or is it like the non-football? There's like a non-injury. I guess it's injury reserve. But what happened with him? I don't remember hearing anything. And how about a Maurice Hurst out of 75 going to the Oakland Raiders? Thumb injury. Man, a lot of finger injuries this year, man. Maybe I'm just have taken notice to those more. So how many of you guys did football? We're going to do a post starting tomorrow on people sharing out. Because I know nobody likes to sit necessarily and listen to everyone else's football teams, fantasy football teams. But on this new football page we're starting, I'm going to start the very first post on it. It's going to be a chance for you to share out your like favorite, maybe favorite fantasy team. Out of 25, Big Dick Nick. Nick Foles, this is why Didi's going to be a top. I got to say top 15 to be safe. Top 15 receiver this year. Locked as QB2 in 12 years. You think, yeah, I know everyone's making these jokes that Brady's going to last forever. Rich, Michael Thomas, Dak Prescott. And speaking of Stidham, you talked him into a hit, man, a lot of war room. Is this our third war room hit already? Sometimes we'll go through a half with just one. We're two boxes in. We got three war room hits. Jarrett Stidham. There we go. And another Niners hit out of 50. Let's get a little Debo. Bears, Packers is 4 days away. Dude, it's so crazy how excited I am about that. I should not be this excited as a grown man for football. But I am, and I'm okay with it. No, Debo, Jack, and Mike's. We got to get a next Friday drop or something. I'm actually in my... So I'm in a 32-team league fantasy league. Now, again, it's 16 and 16. It's an AFC and an NFC. And so each 16-team league is based on a full player pool. And I'm actually doing I'm in both leagues, the AFC and the NFC. I'm actually the Ravens, believe it or not, in the AFC. And I'm the Bucks in the NFC. I didn't get the pick. I inherited the team. But... You keep five players, so there's already, what, like 90 players gone when you get into the draft. And so all rookies are eligible, obviously. And no vets can be kept before the fifth round, but I'm drafting now. I had the second pick. Josh Jacobs went first. I ended up taking Devin Singletary with the second. I'm not super confident in it. I don't necessarily love the pick. It was a little bit of a homer pick. I don't generally do that, but with the news of McCoy leaving yesterday... there we go. 3 out of 5, Will Greer. That's a nice one. 3 out of 5 going to the Carolina Panthers. Alex, nice short pick. Hold on, my brother's in that league. He said he just made a trade. I didn't really see the trade details. What did you do? Will Greer, 3 out of 5. He just made a big trade, I guess. We're going to put that up there as a little bit of a highlight. Another war room. Dude, this is crazy. And it is official. The Niners, Joshua Long on fire. I know, Kelly. What are they doing? They're just completely destroying that team. They're clearly going for the first pick next year. I think everyone hates Adam Gase or whatever, and they just, nobody wants to be there. That whole org, that was an awful hire. And for the Minnesota Vikings, going out to a Minnesota fan, how about some Eric Kendricks, a guy you don't see too often on the autos. There you go.
my secret team. No, I love Nick Mullins, but by no means is the Niners my secret team. And guys, I will have to take a second here to draft. This is what the draft looks like. Won't be great until Rodgers gets fired from coaching. Amen, dude. I just read that. The Packers have some internal issues. So just kind of let you know how this draft goes. Josh Jacobs went first. Singletary went second. Montgomery went third. It is not PPR. It's very traditional scoring. It's like 1 point for every 25 yards. You know, it is no point extra bonus points. It's a very basic scoring league. It's been going on forever, decades. And then Miles Sanders went fourth. So you can see it's a hot, heavy, it's hard to get running backs in this league. It's a heavy rookie running back draft. So Jacobs, Singletary, Montgomery, Sanders. Here, actually, I'll bring you over to it. It's on a weird site. So I just want to share it with you quick. I'll put this pack down. Actually, let's get through this pack and I'll show you. I don't want an open pack. Darius Leonard and Julio Jones. Because I'll probably have to make my pick by then. Emmanuel Hall out of 100 for the Chicago Bears. DJ Moore out of 75. Player worn and used materials. Little piece of a glove or something there. Out of 75 going to the Carolina Panthers. That is going to be going to Alex, along with that. Really, Alex is fairly new getting in here. Alex having a good start to his membership here. And for the Dolphins, is he still on the team or did they get rid of him already too as a rookie? Miles Gaskin out of 50 going to the Miami Dolphins. There you go. That one going out to local Dolphins fan. Oh, wait, did I mix that up? Miami Dolphins. Martin got the Dolphins and Chris Miller got the Colts. Is that correct? Oh, that's Chris Morris, not Chris Miller. Chris Miller's our Dolphins fan. All right, guys, let me see if I'm up here. If Arizona, I know I said that already. Like, what are they going to do? Just keep drafting quarterbacks? I'm up in one pick. We'll look at it right after this box before we do the second half. We'll get through this, and then you guys can see my live draft pick for that league. They're moving to the XFL with Luck. Who knows? Dude, they can't. This is what I don't get about Miami. Buffalo's always under the radar, like, oh, they need to change cities. Buffalo sells out football games. Just so you're clear, it is what Buffalo does. Is Buffalo does the hockey and football. That's all that's left there. And they sell out their games, and they love it, and they live for it. And it's just blue-collar, work all week, go to the games on the weekend kind of thing, right? And out of 75, Keelan Doss, he's a fan favorite locally. And they want him to move. And it's like, why? They do great on sales for product. They sell out games. But then there's Miami. Miami and Jacksonville, who can't put people in the seats, right? Out of 100, clearly they're tanking. Why are they not being moved? Move Miami. Move Jacksonville. Get them out of there. Why do they have two teams there? Doss got waived. He'll get picked up. He had a really good preseason. I think he'll get picked up somewhere. I honestly do. I'm excited for that guy to be in the NFL. I hope he does. He's a cool guy, too. He's funny. Out of 199, maybe starting week one, most likely, getting definite time. What else is there to do in Buffalo? Drink and jump through tables. That's what we do. Another Niners out of 25. Holy cow. I'm sorry, guys. I swear I didn't pack the boxes to favor Josh. I didn't win his Raz either. I'm not, like, paying him back or anything. Josh razzed off that beautiful Murray last night. I lost. I had two spots. But there you go. Nikki Bosa. Dude, Joshua, you are on fire, my friend. Let's get you stickered up. That one is out of 25. Bosa. It's a Niners break. They went late, too. Everyone had a chance at them. I think they were like the fifth from last team taken. They were just hanging tight there. One of the reasons they are priced a little higher is not just because of Bosa, but because they do have so many hits. If you look at their hit count, they're always way, way, way up there in hit count. Same thing with the Raiders. Always got a ton of hits. So if you, I've said this before, some of you guys, if you're just always looking to get your team, don't deviate. If you're just PCing like Scott, although Scott did get a Rams hit the other day when he didn't get a Seahawks. That was funny. But look, dude, look at checklists. Sometimes there's the, you know, you can play the odds. Bills don't have a bad state. Bills have an awesome stadium. I love it. What are you talking about? It could use some improvements. All right, guys, I'm waiting for this guy to pick. Real quick before I open the next. John, what did you say? I told you, John, what there is to do in Buffalo. You said, what is there to do in Buffalo? And I said, get drunk and jump through tables. Maybe beer bong stuff off of the off of butt cracks like they've done in the past. Actually, my cousin just messaged me today and said he's reading this book called Squish the Fish. Dude, I got to show you the message from him. He's like, he was recommended to me, but it has pictures from the Bills games in it. I got to show it to you guys real quick. This is the cover. It's called Squish the Fish. Let me see if I can get you guys here. All right. A Tale of Dating and Debauchery. Debauchery or debauchery? I don't know that word. I mean, I know what it means. And like, these are pictures from real Bills games. That's funny, though. That's how the Bills roll. All right, my pick is up. Sorry, I know you guys are here for a break, but here, I'll let you guys see it with me. Ready? All right. So, a little background. Real quick. We're going to go into my team. I'll let you see my roster real fast. If you guys don't mind me doing this, I know like we talk about fantasy football a ton. This is the AFC. So right now I'm sitting on Chris Carson, Royce Freeman, Alvin Kamara, and Devin Singletary. And then my receivers are Keenan Allen and Calvin Ridley. Now I don't have a quarterback yet. There is no tight end spot. Tight ends count as receivers. So we're going to hop into the draft here. I'd love to get a good receiver here, but I'm not opposed to taking another running back if it sits there. So right here is your top eight projected ADP. Again, it doesn't really take rookies into account. So I'm just going to see what running backs are there. Like Darwin Thompson would have been probably gone already had they not signed McCoy. I mean, there's some good. Now, no vets can be kept here. There's no, if they're not a rookie, they can't be kept. It's before the fourth or fifth round. Man, this is tough. Anybody have suggestions? I'm looking for suggestions, honestly. I don't like any of these. I mean, DK looking forward, but I don't think he's going to be a huge impact this year. Let's see who's at QB. Man, I almost got to go Cam with the running touchdowns. And Josh Allen can't be kept. It's hard not to take another running back here. Dookie, Kenyon. All right, guys, I need your opinions on that. You've seen who is there. Who do you guys recommend that I take? I know I'm kind of thinking. Yeah, I think I'm going to go Cam Newton here and really lock down a good quarterback. I mean, Breeze is there. They're talking about him having a huge year. But yeah, I'm going to lock down Cam as my quarterback and pray he has that nasty year we've been hoping he has. Just give me 1 second, guys. It is a pretty serious league, but how do I draft? There we go. I'm done. It's time to go. Dude is a walking injury. I know. I thought of that. So what I'm gonna do, Brandon, is I'll draft Trubisky in four rounds. because it'll be after the fifth round and I can keep him. Or if Allen falls, if I get lucky and Allen falls the 501. So in this league, it's kind of crazy. Thanks for waiting, guys. I do appreciate it. It is a draft day for me. But they're actually live. That is a live draft, but you can opt to draft online. I've never missed a year of the live, but I had such a long live draft yesterday that I decided I was not going to that one today too. I wanted to break cards. Anyhow, oh, we should be finding our kaboom in here too. You know what, Brandon? It's funny because I've really fallen back on my hope for the Bears a little bit. I'm not ready to pull out and say I don't believe in them as a Super Bowl contender yet, but I am a little nervous about them as my Super Bowl pick. Now, I did say that was my preseason pick. Once I see like week one or two, I may say, here's who I feel now. And it generally is off, you know, I don't just go off the what everyone's saying or the odds. But I know, go tell Bryce to come in. Peyton Manning out of 75. Did you see him get baptized by the Bears? If you haven't, go to ESPN.com. Check out him getting baptized for the Bears. He comes up with a mustache. There we go. Washington Redskins going out to Chris England, Terry McLaurin. Terry McLaurin for the Washington Redskins. And Darrell Henderson out of 50. For the Rams. David Johnson out of 100 for the Arizona Cardinals. Seahawks not expected, verbal entertainment expected. Is that what you're here for? Just to hear me probably make a fool of myself and make bets that I can't cash? Write checks I can't cash. Daniel Jones for our fifth war room. It's a war room break. I have never seen so many come out. Daniel Jones, war room. And, hey, I'll take that out of 40. Daniel Jones for the New York Football Giants. Who's got them Giants? How about them Giants? Chris Volk with another banger. Chris is back, guys.
Kaboom!
New York Giants getting a banger right there. I don't know, man. I'm thinking week four he's in. Out of 40. Let me go get a 55-point mag case. So, how many of you guys have done multiple drafts? Is there any player that you guys seem to be maybe drafting over and over again in your leagues? Rather, you've done mocks or you've done, you know, anything of the sort, like maybe multiple fun drafts or Daniel Jones out of 40. Yeah, see, a lot of everyone does it. And this is my point. A couple people wrote, this is why you don't draft before the preseason is over, right? When like Cam got hurt or who else was a big injury thing. Like, Cam's not even out. Oh, Andrew Luck retired, right? Okay, I get it. I think it happened. But guess what? Before you were getting Devin Singletary in the 8th round and McCoy in the 10th, guess what? You're not getting either of them, I don't think, right now below the 6th round. How can you turn up McCoy in the top-rated offense in the league? How can you turn down, you know, a guy like Devin Singletary now who could possibly be a David Montgomery? And don't say that there's no chance he couldn't be, because he's going to have the bulk of the carries. Damian Williams, Scott? Yeah, that sucks. What do you mean takes Cooks? Dalvin Cook is not hurt, right? Oh, you're saying once he inevitably goes down. I hope not. I spent way too much on that auction league on him. We got a Baker Mayfield and a Russell Wilson. All right, guys. Scott, I know your answer to this, but when it's all said and done, when both players are at the end of their career, who do you think has better numbers, Mayfield or Russell Wilson? Scott's going to hate that question, and I think you're going to hate the answers you see. N'Keal Harry out of 199, along with a Sony Michel. Kelly, do you think McCoy goes up? That's not even, everyone's Mayfield hating. I think if Mayfield comes out this year and the Browns do really well, the whole Mayfield, he's young, he's immature, he's always in trouble. I think it kind of goes away a little bit. This is Mayfield's career make or break year, in my opinion. Because if he can't do it with this team, if he can't manage that locker room, getting older is not going to help him. I just think people are putting way too much on his childhood antics. Out of 75, Miles Garrett. That was a Dexter Williams going out to the Green Bay Packers. That's a guy in late leagues you can get. Well, here's the thing, Bo. Bosa's been talking, been taking Darrell Henderson. I think it's a great pick as long as you can get Gurley. Gurley's going at the end of the second round, early third round right now. Dude, that means you could potentially have Ezekiel Elliott as the 4th or 5th pick right now. He's going to play this year. He's not sitting out. They can hold him for 5 years. It's just a matter of numbers at this point. And they're playing a game of chicken. And apparently Jerry Jones is and Zeke have the same mindset. They're going to crash into each other. But they're coming out both without scratches because they're going to win. Both sides are winning in that. That was an awful analogy. I'm sorry. What I'm saying, though, is you could potentially get Zeke as pick 5, all right? That's about where he's going, pick 4 or 5. On the wrap, you could take Gurley. So now you have potentially if Gurley holds up and Zeke signs, the top two of the top 3 or 4 running backs in the league. And then you can start pounding out wide receivers, right? Get 2 or 3 receivers. And then in the 5th, 6th round, grab Darrell Henderson as the backup to Gurley if he goes down, just to, you know, protect your investment. Dude, you're sitting golden. You can worry about quarterback and tight end later. How the hell did you? Oh, yeah, Saquon. All right, there's another one. Saquon and Gurley. There he goes. That's another example. Saquon, even. If you're confident, because I'm sure you had to take Saquon first, right, Brandon? Goose, what up, Goose? Goose is back. Everyone say hi to Goose. It's good to see you, buddy. Even if it's just stopping in to say hi, man, that is awesome. Man, good to see you. I was looking for my welcome back drop. I can't find it, but welcome back, dude. That's awesome. Peterman is better than Allen. You're probably right. But you're not going to hear arguments from me. I said Peterman was the man. I didn't sell his rookie card yet, mostly because I can't get more than $1 for his autograph. But how about another War Room? This one out of 49, 2-color. I've not seen this. This is our, like, what, 5th case of this? And I have never seen so many War Rooms. I was going to say, Brandon, you're like, if you got that, that's great, but I would never do that strategy thinking I could get Saquon and Gurley. If he fell to me, great. I don't think so yet, Max. Oh, you're going to love this one. 96 out of 99 for them Seahawks, Scotty. There you go. One of my favorite backs took him in the second round. It was a keeper league, so it wasn't real second round. Chris Carson out of 99. What's up? Oh, my goodness. King Damon now again. I'm going to be confused. Is it Allen or is it? Yeah, it's Allen, right? Brandon, I've been saying that in PPR leagues, I think, too. I've been saying that for a while. I own more Chris Carson and Le'Veon Bell. Like, they're probably about the same. If I couldn't get Le'Veon in the first, generally I got someone else and grabbed Chris Carson in the loop or got both of them. So, yeah, what's up, Alan? Sorry, I told you before, I get you confused with Josh because of the dual Facebook names. That's cool. We have zero delay. Maybe it was the update. Wait, Austin Hooper was a pickup for you? Nobody drafted him? Is it? This got to be a 10-person league, right? Adams and Adams, Jamal and Devontae. And for the Redskins, how about a little Darius Geis? I hope him and Cook both show up from 17. Oh, now see, that is the only league where Mahomes should go first pick. Two QB leagues, if you're not taking Mahomes first, you're dumb. It's literally like saying he's your flex spot. If you could put Mahomes in a flex spot, absolutely. Dude, that's crazy. People just don't know that. Like, they don't understand the value of a quarterback in two QB leagues. Rodney Anderson out of 25. Once we heard he got injured, we pulled him in like every box of Trinity and every auto possible. Rodney Anderson out of 25. And Dwayne Haskins out of 50 going to the Skins. Nice short print rookie. I mean, here's the thing though, Goose. Patrick Mahomes shouldn't be taken before the third round, really the fourth round in one QB leagues. It's just you can't make up for it. I just don't think it's you can make up for it. Mahomes is the only one that should even be going that early. He's the biggest point differential, but we'll see. I may not know. I probably don't know anything. I was supposed to get my fantasy football championship belt yesterday, and the dude didn't bring it to the draft. It's going to go right below that Buffalo. That's why it's so high so it can fit there. Kamara, CMC, Saquon, DeAndre Hopkins. Oh, man. Kamara and CMC went before Saquon. Well, dude, that means, yeah, there's a lot more guys there I think would have been valuable than Mahomes. But hey, you know what? It might end up paying off. Speaking of Mahomes, out of 100, Patrick Mahomes, red zone. Put a little ketchup on that touchdown. Josh said any Niners hits. You might as well leave before you get verbally assaulted in here. Eighth pick sucks, but Scott, you probably could have grabbed his receiver, Kelsey. Not his receiver, but he's going to be one of his top receivers. Who'd you take with the eighth pick then, Scott? I'm curious. Oh, Rodney Anderson out of 199. If you took... Holy shit. It's another Niners hit. Josh comes in. Guys, I'm sorry. Like, I'll add an extra hitless credit to it. I've never seen... Oh, yeah, in two QB leagues. Yeah. Goose, you got him in a two QB... Oh, yeah, then that's a great deal. Top five. Holy shit, he should have went first. James Conner. I just watched a highlight reel of James Conner, and I made this mistake last year with Leonard Fournette. James Conner definitely moved up on my draft board. Yeah, it's that heavy. I'm giving away bonus hitless credit. Vote. I agree, man. I've been getting him at 8 and 9. And the other day I had a pick at like number 3, last box mojo. Oh, nice, DJ. That's a card you might want to look at moving this year, or I don't know. Running backs just tend to not hold long, super long-term value. You know, it's a matter of getting it into a PC. Are you a Steelers fan? If you're a Steelers fan, that's an awesome PC card. Don't be sorry for getting hits, Josh. Don't be sorry at all. Guys, just so you know, if you do take Bell, don't be afraid to pick up Ty Montgomery. They released Elijah Maguire yesterday. And Ty Montgomery, they must believe in Ty Montgomery, Stephon Gilmore. Ty Montgomery, that much. Ben Roethlisberger, red zone, top 100. All right, well, we are definitely going to be giving some bonuses out. I may throw in a bonus silver pack because it looks like we have one more P word, so I may be giving you guys, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I am going to give away a bonus silver and two $5 hitless credits. How does that sound? The silver, everyone is eligible for. The two $5 hitless credits will only go to hitless teams. Team Tander, Madison, and Cook. My only complaint about this product is how many points they put in it. Out of 49. Are you, DJ, are you a, that's awesome, man. I'm glad you're not, like, it's cool to see guys that are just PC and Travion Williams out of 100. Chris, that's what I'm saying. AB's dropping the late second round, early third round, along with like Gurley. So let's just say hypothetically, perfect scenario right here. You draft like second, right? So you grab CMC, Kamara, Le'Veon even, I don't care. You get a top running back. You loop around and get Gurley, and you loop back around and can snag Antonio Brown in the third. Could you imagine the start to that team? Another 400. So here's the question, guys. Do we want to give the 800, which is a nice, actually nice point prize. Do we want to do the 800 together or 400 separate? First to get to three. 800 together, 400 separate. Together or separate is all you have to say. And that's how we'll random them. But also, I'm giving away two $5 hitless credits as well. And a silver pack that everyone's eligible for. They will be given out with the silver pack. It will go silver. So we have separate, together. Who's going to be the tiebreaker? First to three. I said it from the start. Separate, together. Out of 50, N'Keal Harry for the New England Patriots. All right. So Chris broke it with separate. So it's going to be silver pack, 400 points, 400 points, plus two $5 hitless credits. All right, we'll do that at the end. We got an Aaron Donald and Bruce. Bruce out of 75. And Holyfield. I almost said Mayfield. Holyfield out of 199 for the Panthers. Hey, there we go. For the Cincinnati Bengals, going out to Justin Kafka. Ryan Finley. Scott, did you say who you got at 8? Did you say Bell? I was curious who you did get. Did you even say? Lev Bell, you did. Yeah, why? He's falling so short. So there are leagues that draft after the first week. I would love to see how everything changes in one of those leagues, right? Like, compare it to... Yeah, we're going to post a little four-box random teams up around 2:30. Actually, I'll probably post it for 3 o'clock, Brandon. Just do a little random teams four-box. James Conner out of 75. Going to try to keep it a little more cost-friendly. I'm trying to keep it like 25 and under and still get a lot in there. So we'll see. Joe Flacco and Derek Carr. DeAndre Hopkins. I think he's still going to finish number one. DeAndre Hopkins. And Julian Love out of 75 for the Giants to close it out. All right, guys, we have lots to give away. We have a recap to do, so stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. We have 800 points total to give out. We have a silver pack. Let me grab the silver pack so I don't forget. We have a silver pack to give out. We have, two $5 hit list silver pack and 800 points. So here we go. Let's recap a while first before we do any of that. Michael Thomas on top? I hope so. I have him in my dynasty. Here we go. Damian Harris out of 100. Connor out of 75. Smith out of 75. Harry out of 50. Travion Williams out of 100. Ben out of 100. Connor out of 100. Mahomes out of 100. Haskins out of 50. Kelsey out of 75. Garrett out of 75. Johnson out of 100. Henderson out of 50. Manning out of 75, Elliott out of 100, Doss out of 75, Emmanuel Hall out of 100, Foles out of 25. We got Hurst out of 75, Fitzgerald out of 100, Armstead out of 100, Calvin Johnson out of 100, Tre'Davious White out of 100, Sutton out of 75, none out of 10. Craziness. So you guys think Thomas over Hopkins this year? So you guys just kind of gave me an idea. I want to do, if you ever listen to any like the old ESPN, well, it's still on, but I don't know if they do it on, they do that. Put it on the board, right? They make these board bets. We need to get a board bet going on that fantasy page. And that way people can make little friendly wagers. I don't want like big money involved, but we can go back and look at it then, right? So we can maybe make a tag for it or something. And then we can go back and look at everybody's picks down the road then and see who made little wagers and stuff. I think that'd be fun. Here we go. DeAndre Hopkins for the Houston Texans going to Corey. Madison and Cook, Minnesota Vikings going out to Bo. Bo getting a couple hits. Darius Geis for the Washington Redskins, Chris England. N'Keal Harry, New England Patriots, going out to Richard Blaney. Lots of war room swatches. Another New England Patriots, N'Keal and Sony. And Daniel Jones, war room rookie, going out to the New York Giants, going out to Chris Volk. Carolina Panthers, DJ Moore, going out to Alex Riegel. Nick Bosa, San Francisco 49ers, going out to Josh, one of the many Niners cards. Jarrett Stidham. Man, I didn't realize Patriots did that well either. Philadelphia Eagles. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside going out. We didn't. Dude. That's BS. Absolute is a great mixer product. I said it from the start. And you know what? We will go ahead and do some of that Leaf. Do you guys like Leaf Trinity? We'll throw some of that in the mixer. Dallas Cowboys, Trey Sett, and Washington Redskins, Bryce Love. Let's do the autographs first. New York Giants, Chris Vogt getting the Julian Love. Cincinnati Bengals, Justin Kafka. Seattle Seahawks, Chris Carson going out to Scott Ripley. Don't see a ton of his autographs. And Damian Williams, Green Bay Packers, Andrew Lewis. Man, it was kind of spread out. That's the banger. Let's see that. Miami Dolphins, Martin Van Buhl getting the Gaskin auto. And Eric Kendricks for the Minnesota Vikings. San Francisco 49ers, Debo. And Austin Bryant out of 35 going to the Detroit Lions, Pete Nico. And then here is our Cincinnati Bengals, Ryan Finley. And here we go with these repetitive Niners hits. Nick Bosa out of 149 going to the San Francisco 49ers. Terry McLaurin for the Washington Redskins going to the going to Chris England. We got the Nick Bosa out of 25 going to the Niners. Holy cow. Drew Locke for the Denver Broncos going to John Salgado. New England Patriots getting the nanny, N'Keal Harry, and Dante Pettis out of 35 going to the Niners, and Daniel Jones. All right, guys, first thing we're going to do is do the two $5 hit list credits. We'll bang that out. Then we're going to give away the silver 400 points. I can't believe all the moves yesterday. It was kind of crazy how much really went down yesterday. I mean, I knew that it wasn't 4 o'clock, the deadline yesterday. Oops. To do something here. All right, here we go. Bringing you over to the screen. Two $5 hitless credits, 9, 1, 19. Falcons and Rams are going to get it. That is going to be Alex Riegel, and the LA Rams are going to be TJ Erb getting the $5 hitless credits. All right. Now here's what we're going to do. First place on this is going to win the silver pack. Second place is going to get 400 points. Third place is going to get 400 points. All right. First gets silver. Second gets 400 points. Third gets 400 points. Min roll 5. Here we go, guys. Good luck, everybody. I can't see chat if you're chatting. This is my window that I look at chat on that you guys are watching. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Bo getting the silver. Martin getting 400. Chris Morris getting 400. Bo, last time you got a pack. We know what happened there. Let's see what happens today, all right? So, Bo Brennan getting the silver. Martin getting 400. Chris getting 400. Here we go. Let's do this silver. Let me get your name on it here. Bo, good luck to you, friend. $100? What's $100? How about 10 out of 10? Harry Kane. Bo, I don't know what this goes for, but I know the eBay goes crazy over the soccer stuff. 100. Oh, what is it? Percent. I don't know if you set me up there, Ron, but you got me. 100. What? 100 what? Percent skunk. Sorry, I don't mean to laugh at your skunking as much as your joke. Or if it was just not a joke, I'm sorry. I laughed at it. All right, guys. Check us out around 3 o'clock. I'll post a 4-box random teams. We fight to see another day. At least we're not the Miami Dolphins. You could be a member of the Miami Dolphins. Life could get worse for you. Dolphins. It's nice that the Bills only have two other teams to lose to now. Here we go. Have a good one. I'll see you.